If you want to make any lens with any material, it should be transparent. So clay is not transparent, therefore option D is the proper answer for this one. Now the image formed by a concave mirror is observed to be virtual, erect and larger than the object. Where should be the position of the object? We know that concave mirror gives the real image all the time, but only it does not give the real image when it is kept in between focus and pole. Therefore it should be kept in between focus and pole so that we can get the virtual image, erect image, at the same time larger. So here option D, between the pole of the mirror and its principal focus, is the correct answer, and this is the corresponding diagram for it. Third question, where should an object be placed in front of convex lens to get a real image of the size of the object? Just in the previous problems, one of the previous problems, we discussed the size of the object and size of the image remain same only when the object is kept at twice the focal length. When the object is kept at 2f1, the image is obtained at 2f2, that is on the other side of the lens. Therefore the option B is the correct one, and this is the corresponding diagram for it. Now here in this question, a spherical mirror and a thin spherical lens, each a focal length of minus 15 centimeters, the mirror and the lens are likely to be. So here, according to the sign convention of new Cartesian coordinates, both the two concave surfaces, therefore the choice is option A, both should be concave. Now this is how we have learned the sign conventions. In the case of mirror, it is always measured from P. In the case of lens, it is always measured from the center of the lens. So when we measure the measurements in towards the left, it is negative, towards the right it is positive, upwards is positive and downwards it is negative. So this is the concave mirror. So as it is having its focus on the left side, so we are measuring towards left, therefore it's negative. Similarly, in the case of concave lens, we have to measure it from the center of the lens, and its focus, virtual focus, is there on the left side, therefore both the two having negative focal lengths. So the answer is both concave. No matter how far you stand from a mirror, your image appears erect. The mirror is likely to be, it can be either plane or convex, therefore the option is D. We can see here a man is standing in front of the plane mirror. So he will have the same height in the mirror, but all the time it is erect only. Same is the case with the convex mirror. We will have the erect. Even the nearest car is also looking like erect image only, and the farthest objects are also erect only. Which of the following lenses would you prefer to use while reading a small letters found in a dictionary? So here, of course, if you want to see the dictionary, you require a magnifier. A magnifier is nothing but a convex lens, and if the convex lens is having lesser focal length, its power is more. Here there are two answers could be possible: a convex lens of focal length 50 centimeters and convex lens of focal length 5 centimeters. Both can give the enlarged images, but when we compare these two, this 5 centimeters one will give more clearly the larger images. So it is always better use, if you have two convex lenses with you, better use the convex lens with the lower focal length. Now we wish to obtain an erect image of an object using a concave mirror of focal length 15 centimeters. So here what is given? F is given as 15 centimeters. In all optics problems, you must write along with the sign conventions. So here, using concave mirror, it's given. Therefore, the focal length f is equal to, not to be written as 15 alone, it should be minus 15. Next, what should be the range of distance of the object from the mirror? What is the nature of the image? Is the image larger or smaller than object? Draw a ray diagram to show the image formation in this case. Here, the focal length of the concave mirror is given as 15 centimeters. I told that we have to write it as minus 15, of course. When the object is kept between the pole and focus, the concave mirror will give us the enlarged erect image. So you can, from the pole up to focus, you can keep the object anywhere in between pole and focus. Therefore, the range must be 15. So that is the answer for the first bit. Next, what is the nature of the image? It is virtual. And then, is the image larger or smaller than the object? It is larger all the time. I have to take a concave mirror. This is the pole and this is the focus. Let this be center of curvature. Now let me take one object. Let me name it as AB. Now I have to take two rays, one ray which is passing parallel to the principal axis and then it goes back through focus, the other one which is striking at P, this will be reflected, making the same angle. So here, if you extend these two, these will never meet. Therefore, I have to extend this with dotted lines in the forward direction. Therefore, I get this as the position of the image. This is corresponding to A dash, let me name it, and this is corresponding to B dash. Now, if you look at this, the size of the A dash B dash is greater than AB, and as it is obtained on the other side of the mirror or behind the pole of the mirror, it is virtual. Other property is, it is an erect image. So all the things were covered. Name the type of mirror used in the following situation. 1. Headlights of a car. 2. Side or rear view mirror in vehicles. And 3. Solar furnaces. Of course, headlights of a car, we have to use concave mirrors so that to get a powerful beam of light. Then, rear view mirror, we have already seen that convex mirrors are used. Then, in solar furnace, we have to concentrate the heat at one particular point. Therefore, concave mirrors are to be used. Now, next question. One half of a convex lens is covered with a black paper. Will this lens produce a complete image of the object? So, actually, it gives the complete image, but here in this problem, height of the object is given. U is given as 25 centimeters, but we always take the object distance as minus. So minus 25 centimeters, as it is converging lens, which is convex lens, whose focal length is positive. After that, I have to write the formula. And the formula says 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. This is called lens formula. And I wanted to get V. Therefore, I will shift all other terms to right side. So 1 by U plus 1 by F. And here, I have to apply the values with sign. So 1 by minus 25, that is U value, and 1 by 10. So we get minus 2 plus 5 by 50, which is plus 3 by 50. Therefore, V is equal to 50 by 3, which is positive positive 16.7. Now we know that magnification M is equal to V by U. So here it is plus 50 by 3 minus 25, which gives us minus 2 by 3. So height of the image is equal to minus 2 by 3 times of height of the object. So which gives us width negative 3.333 centimeters, and then this negative sign indicates that the image is inverted and it is diminished, of course, as the object height is 5 and the image height is 3.3, which is lesser than that of height of the object. Draw the ray diagram. That means I have to draw here, not to scale, of course, with the help of proper scale and pencil you can draw in a better way. So let me 10 10, and then let us consider each unit to be 10 centimeters. Then it is the object, and here this will be 10 centimeters. Therefore this will go like this, and then this is the image. This is 16.7, and this is each 10, 25 centimeter. So you can draw this diagram by taking 5 centimeters one unit in a graph paper very neatly. The next problem: a concave lens of focal length 15 centimeter forms an image 10 centimeters from the lens. How far is the object placed from the lens? Draw ray diagram. So here the focal length is given, that is minus 15. Why it is minus? Because it is concave lens. Next, V is 10 centimeters from the lens it is obtained. Of course, in concave lens all the time the virtual image is framed, therefore on the same side of the lens the image is formed. It should also be negative. So U we wanted to calculate, therefore 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. So 1 by V, that is minus 10, minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by minus 15, and this 10 goes to this side, it becomes positive. And if 30 is the LCM, minus 2 plus 3 by 10, therefore 1 by 30. So here 1 by U is equal to 1 by 30, therefore U is equal to minus 30. This should be negative 30. So this would be the diagram for it. In this case, an object is placed at a distance of 10 centimeters from convex mirror of focal length 15 centimeters. Find the position and nature of the image. So it is convex mirror, therefore focal length should be positive, so plus 15, and U is always negative, therefore minus 10 centimeters, and we have to find out the value of V. Mirror formula we have to use: 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F, and 1 by V is equal to 1 by F minus 1 by U, which is 1 by 15, this is with plus, minus 1 by minus 10. Therefore the LCM would be 30, and it becomes of course positive, 2 plus 3, which gives us 5 by 30, that is 1 by 6. Therefore V is equal to plus 6, that is on the right side or behind the pole you will get. The nature is, it is virtual diminished and erect, formed behind the pole. So this is the solution for this problem. The magnification produced by a plane mirror is +1. What does this mean? So it indicates two things. Plus indicates that it is erect. The magnitude 1 indicates that the ratio of V and U, or the ratio of height of the image and height of the object, is same. That is equal to 1. Therefore HI by HO is equal to 1. Therefore HI is equal to HO. Now here, an object of 5 cm in length is placed at a distance of 20 cm in front of convex mirror of radius of curvature 30 cm. Find the position of the image, its nature. Now, placed at a distance 20 cm in front of convex mirror. So, U is equal to minus 20 cm. Radius of curvature is given as +30. Why? Because it is convex. Therefore, immediately you must calculate the focal length, which is equal to 30 by 2, which gives us 15 centimeter. Once you know these things, immediately we must write the mirror formula as V require 1 by V here actually. Therefore, 1 by F minus 1 by U. When we replace the values, this minus and U is also negative, therefore it becomes positive 20. So we can get the LCM as 60. So 4 plus 3. Therefore V is equal to 60 by 7 centimeters. You can divide this 60 by 7. 7 8s are 56, and then 4, then 7 5s are 0.5, 35, 50, and then 7 7s are. So it is 8.57 centimeters. It is with positive we got, therefore it is again behind the pole only. Position of the image means behind the pole 8.57 centimeters. Nature, it is erect, then virtual, it is diminished. We have to calculate the magnification, which is equal to minus V by U, that is minus 60 by 7, and this U is minus 20. Therefore, finally the answer is 3 by 7. Therefore, height of the image is equal to 3 by 7 times 5, which gives us 15 by 7. So, it is 2.1 centimeter. An object of size 7 centimeters. So, height of the object is given 7 centimeters. Now place 27 centimeters in front of concave mirror. So U is equal to minus 27 centimeter, and then the focal length is also negative for concave mirror, therefore minus 18 centimeter. At what distance from the mirror should a screen be placed? That means we have to calculate the V. To get the sharp focused image obtained, find the size and the nature of the image. So, HI. So, here again we will have to make use of mirror formula, which 1 by V is equal to 1 by F minus 1 by U when we substitute the values minus 1 by 18 and it becomes plus 1 by 27, the LCM would be 54. Then it is minus 3 and it is 2, therefore minus 1 by 54, therefore V is equal to minus 54 centimeters. That means you have to keep the screen at 54 centimeters from the pole. Okay, so now what is the magnification? Magnification is equal to minus V by U, that is minus 54 by U, that is minus 27, which gives us 2 with negative, because 1 negative is cancelled, the 27 2s are. So therefore height of the image is equal to twice the height of the object, which is 2 into 7 centimeters, therefore 14 centimeter is the height of the image. Now what is the nature? It is real. As the magnification has turned out to be negative, therefore it is inverted. Magnification is twice, therefore it is enlarged. Find the focal length of a lens of power minus 2 diopter. Power is negative, therefore it should be concave. And then we know that focal length is equal to reciprocal of power, 1 by p, that is 1 by minus 2, which gives us 0.5 meter with negative. Next, a doctor has prescribed a corrective lens of power plus 1.5 diopter. Find the focal length of the lens. Is the prescribed lens diverging or converging? So as it is indicating positive, it should be converging lens. To obtain focal length, we have to take the reciprocal of power, that is 1 by 1.5, which gives 66.67 centimeters. So with that, we have completed all the questions. I hope that you would have enjoyed the way of answering these questions. Please do not forget to subscribe the channel. In my next video, I'll be giving the solutions for human eye and colorful world. Thank you.